Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And you ever wanted to give the people that are just viewers of a workspace or people that consume your reports via an app a little more flexibility so that they can switch out measures or change columns or even switch visuals? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, you've created some reports and you publish them out to a workspace, and you have a lot of people that are just viewers in the workspace. Or if you've created an app and you've given people access via an app, but they come back and they go, hey, I want to switch from a line chart to a stack column chart, or I want to switch to a table. And they go, I was reading about perspectives and personalized views. It's like, yeah, we're not going to do that. How would you give them that capability? Would you just tell them no? Well, I've come across something that I want to share with you guys, and I haven't tried this in a real world scenario, but I just want to show you and I want to get your feedback. All right. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing I did was I created a couple of field parameters. And if you don't know what field parameters are, I did a video on dynamic X and Y axis, and I talked about field parameters. There's lots of content out on the web. People are going crazy about these field parameters. And what you would do to create them is you would go to modeling and choose new parameter and choose fields. And then once that pops up, you can create the field parameter. Go watch my video. I show you how to do it. Well, with fields is not available. It's a preview feature. So you go to file, options and settings, you choose options, and then click on preview and then choose field parameters. So the first thing I did was I created a field parameter for the columns they would use in their dynamic analysis and the measures they would use. So I created two separate field parameters. Then I picked some visuals that I think they would use in their analysis. So I chose the stack column chart, the line chart, the table in the matrix, pretty popular visuals. And the challenge is narrowing it down. So when you go talk to people about this, they may go, I want all of them. You go, give me your top five. So you put those top five out there. Once I did that, I picked those visuals and I configured those visuals to use my field parameters. So you can see on my line chart, I'm using report columns and report measures. And I did it for each one. After I had those visuals configured and set up, I created a bookmark that would hide all the visuals but that visual. So for this bookmark, it shows the stack column chart. This one shows the line chart. This one showed the table, and this one showed the matrix. If you go to view and look at selection, when I toggle, you can see the ones that hide. So if I click table is visible, but all the other visuals are hidden, and on and so forth. And then I click on the visual and I went to the format option here. Then I chose general and I got a snippet of this, and then I made them all the same height and position. And once I did that, you see, once I toggle across my bookmarks, everything just switches and it looks pretty seamless. Everything's in the same place. And then the last thing I did, I went to insert and I chose buttons and I chose this bookmark navigator, and it automatically created all these buttons for me. Again, you guys know I'm not great at report design, but what I did was I went to the shape and I think I chose like peel or something like that. And now if I click on the line chart, it switches. But one thing I saw is when I choose year and I choose total sales, if I switch to line chart, it lost all of the settings. And so what you would do to persist it, so for example, if I go back to my stat column chart and I choose year and total sales, and I uncheck data, and then I choose update, and then I do the exact same thing for line chart, uncheck data and update. And as I toggle, watch this, if I choose year and total sales, and if I go to the line chart, it holds the data, so it doesn't change it out. You need to play with those properties to make sure they fit the scenario that you're trying to solve. But now I finished all the configuration, I published it out, and then I gave a report viewer access to it. Let me show you. I'm gonna go over up to powerbi.com, and in that workspace, I published the report out and I gave John Doe access, and John Doe was a viewer. And then what I did is I signed in as John Doe on that report. And you can see this is John Doe. John Doe is only a viewer. John can switch between each one of the visuals, just like that. And he can even change what he's analyzing. So you can say, well, I want to look at total sales by quarter or month or gender. But let's stick with year. Then I switch to a line chart, and then I can see sales skyrocketed. If I go to a table, I can see the details. If I go to a matrix, I can actually choose multiple. You can see how it just kind of builds that hierarchy for me, and I can expand and collapse. What do you guys think about this? I'm giving people that can't go into edit mode and switch visuals and change things, I'm giving the ability to do like some self-service analytics of these reports using field parameters. I think this is pretty bananas. All right. I'd love to know if you tried this before. I'd love to know if you've run into some challenges or you have some other ideas. You know what to do. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If this is your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.